We have been told the end of our world will occur on December 21st, 2012. As 2012 draws to a close, will it be the end of our species, the end of our world, or just the beginning?
In case you haven't heard, the world is going to end in 2012.
December 21st, 2012.
The Mayan calendar basically predicts that the world will end in 2012. Oh.
The world is not going to end December 21st, 2012, coming up in just a few days. It is a hoax. It is a premeditated fraud. No Mayan scholars, no archaeologists have ever come out and looked at the Mayan prophecies in the Mayan calendar and said that it states there's going to be an end of the world. The whole thing is a 30-plus year manufactured hoax, a total and complete scam. And we're going to break down exactly who is behind it and why the mainstream media has been peddling this for decades.
Did the Maya think the world would end in 2012? No, they didn't.
Now, the Mayan people are fighting back, saying that the idea of the world coming to an end in 2012 did not come from their calendar.
But where do we find the modern end of the world 2012 cult beginning? New Age thinkers like Terence McKenna and Robert Anton Wilson launched what has become the 2012 doomsday hubbub in the 1970s. They simply used the Mayan date to launch a kickoff of the New Age scenario to garner attention to their other Illuminati New Age writings. Robert Anton Wilson, in his book, The Cosmic Trigger, said that there would be a scientific quickening similar to what Ray Kurzweil says, and that the singularity would begin to happen on December 21st, 2012, and he used the Mayan date as a symbolic trigger for all of this. But there were countless other New Age gurus and establishment-connected types who came out over the next few decades and continued to push this idea that the world would either physically end on December 21st, 2012, or that a New Age would start at that point. And that is exactly what we are seeing being promoted and being pushed right now. This end of the world business is a reoccurring theme throughout history. And it gets people to cop out and to not be involved in their daily lives. It makes you have a feeling of powerlessness. And governments and different institutions have always been happy to promote this. The establishment for hundreds of years has gotten Christians to not be politically involved because going back to the time of the Gnostics, they always believed the world was ending next week. It is a total system to cop out. It is a manufactured superstition. Just as Christians are given the rapture as a reason to stand down and not fight back against corruption and evil, the New Age crowd or the hippies, the trendies, people that didn't believe in God, they needed a reason to not be involved. It is a self-fulfilling prophecy, and that's what the whole 2012 hoax is about. A artificial superstition to make people turn control of their lives over to the globalist technocrats. Strangely enough, we find the answer to our current superstition in ancient cultures like the Mayan. And I don't just want to pick on them. This was system-wide throughout all human cultures that you would see the rise of a priest class who would say, if you don't give us the best huts, the best temples, the best food, and finally human sacrifices, the greatest thing they could demand from the general population, the giant Titan god will swallow the sun, or the snake god will swallow the sun or moon, and it will be the end of the world if you don't give the priest class total control. And that's basically what politicians in Hollywood are doing again today. It's the end of the world with terrorism. It's the end of the world with the economy. If you don't give us more control, we're going to go over the fiscal cliff. You remember Karl Rove when he told the New York Times that it doesn't matter if we lie to people. It doesn't matter if we change the political narrative tomorrow. Up is down, down is up in a 1984 fashion. Because we in the governing class are history's actors now. And you, the public, are in such a coma, you will just accept whatever the new reality is. So sit down and shut up. And that's what these prophets of doom are doing. They are stealing the future. They are prescripting what it's going to be, and then we just fall into line and believe it like they're God. Don't let these people dominate and control the future. conclusion, I want to cover some real threats that could not just destroy the human species, but could destroy this beautiful planet itself. Many top physicists and scientists are on record saying that these giant cyclotrons and superconducting supercolliders like the Hadron facility in Europe are engaged in experiments that could possibly destroy this planet.
By switching on a $10 billion machine in an attempt to recreate the Big Bang. But critics are worried it will create a black hole which could swallow the Earth.
Interestingly enough, CERN goes live on December 16th through the 21st. Many scientists have warned that nanotech could get out of control and create a self-replicating manufacturing system that would overtake the surface of the globe in just a matter of days. In hundreds of major studies, GMO crops that have been eaten by Americans for decades cause near total sterility, brain damage, and deformities in the different rodents that they've been fed to. Major universities for decades have been stampeding each other to publish things like the mousepox recipe that can be redesigned for humans very easily and inexpensively and kills more than 90% of mammal species that come in contact with it. And then, of course, there's the good old-fashioned threat of nuclear weapons, more than 60,000 of them held by governments right now, onboard aircraft, underwater submarines, missile cruisers. Back in the 1960s, many nuclear physicists believed that high-altitude detonations of hydrogen bombs could blow a hole in our atmosphere and that the planet could become dead. Still, the military went ahead with the test.
Teak, with a yield of 3.8 megatons, detonated nearly 50 miles above the surface of the Earth. The detonation created a violent magnetic disturbance in the atmosphere.
And the point I'm getting at here is that the mad scientist technocratic elite that runs our planet always engages in the most destructive, reckless behavior while lecturing us that we need a world government to keep rogue states from developing dangerous chemical, biological, and radiological weapons. The seeds of our destruction may have already been sown. It is imperative that we have a serious debate about the real threats facing us and not raptures and 2012 end of the world garbage. There is no way that our society, that our civilization is going to survive if people don't start really getting wise about the real threats we face. If you are listening or watching this transmission, you are the resistance.